NumPy arrays can be indexed using the standard Python format, using square brackets with an object within. The object defines the type of indexing that will occur. The three types of indexing are element access, basic slicing, and advanced indexing. In this video, we will cover element access and basic slicing, and in the follow-up advanced indexing video, more topics such as Boolean and integer indexing will be covered. To demonstrate indexing a NumPy array, we will create a new script with the NumPy library imported as np. Next, we will create an array called values and set this equal to np.arrange with the integer 9 passed as the first argument within the function. This will create an array with values 0 through 8. We can access each individual element within the array through element access by adding the name of the array values followed by a set of square brackets. Within the square brackets, we will add a single integer 4, which is the index of the fifth value in the array. When the result is printed to the console, we see the element with the value 4 is returned. To return multiple values from the values array, we can use slicing by adding a slice object within the square brackets. The syntax for the slice object has three parts, each separated by a colon: the starting index, the stopping index, and the step size. The first slice object we will pass will have a starting index of 4 and no ending index. This will start the slice at the index 4 and grab all other indices along the same axis. When the result is printed to the console, we see that the values from 4 to 8 are returned. If we want to only select the values 4, 5, and 6, we will add a stopping index to our slice object. To select these values, we will add the index 7 to the slice object, because the selection will be made from the start index 4 up to, but not including the stopping index 7. When the result is printed, we see the values 4, 5, and 6 are returned. To select every other element within the array, we can define a slice object with a starting value of 0, an ending value of 8, and a step size of 2. When the result is printed to the console, we see that the values at index 0, 2, 4, and 6 have been returned. A negative value used as the starting or ending value of a slice is counted from the last element in the array, which means the direction of the step will move towards smaller indices. For example, negative 1 is the last element in the array, and negative 2 is the second to last element, and so on. We will change our slice object to select the same values by assigning negative 3 as the starting value, colon as the ending value, and negative 2 as the step size. When the results are printed to the console, we can see the same values 6, 4, 2, and 0 are returned. Note how the values are returned from largest to smallest because of the direction of the negative step size. For more Python tutorials, like, share, and subscribe to the PyPros channel.